Welcome to iLecture Online. What most people probably don't realize is that when you use a magnifying glass or even a microscope, you can look at it or through it in different ways. You can look through a microscope or look through a magnifying glass in a relaxed fashion or in a strained fashion. You may say, well, definitely I want the relaxed fashion, but not always. There's different reasons why you want to sometimes look in a strained fashion versus a relaxed fashion. So what's the difference? Well, it turns out that you have the ability to look through a magnifying glass and place the image at various locations. For example, as we saw in the previous video, if you place the object pretty close to where the focal point is, at the distance of the focal length from the lens, then you can see how the image will then be formed by this line right here. But you don't have to place the image at a distance of 25 centimeters. You can allow your vision to become relaxed and allow the lens in your eyes to relax in such a way that the image then is pushed further out to a distance far away. So essentially what happens is that the magnified image now becomes an object far away, but the size is always such that the angle of magnification doesn't change. The angle doesn't change, you just place the image farther away. That allows you to look at something as if it was far away, and that makes your eyes more relaxed. A long time ago in my early career, when I was working as an engineer, working with circuit boards and looking at small components and circuit board components and so forth, well, we looked through magnifying glasses a lot. And if you strained yourself through that magnifying glass a lot, you'd get a lot of eye fatigue and you'd start getting a headache. So you want to train yourself to push that image far away so you can look through the magnifying glass essentially all day long, and some people do that for their job. And so that way you don't get tired looking through a magnifying glass. So you simply push the image away, and so the magnification is the way we saw it before. The magnification in that relaxed state, and so maybe we'll write that down. So in the relaxed state, we saw that the magnification was equal to the ratio of the new angle subtended by the image divided by the angle, essentially the angle subtended by the image divided by the angle subtended by the object placed at the same distance. And we saw that this was going to be equal to, in the previous video, we saw that it was essentially equal to 25 centimeters divided by the focal length, which in this case was 25 centimeters divided by 5 centimeters, which was equal to 5. So we saw that that allowed you a magnification of 5. But what we could do instead is we could move the object a little bit closer inside the focal point of the lens, a shorter distance than the distance to the focal point. If we do that, you can see then that you'll get a larger magnification. Then if you bring the image to the distance 25 centimeters away, you can see that you now have a larger image at that location than you had before, simply by putting the object a little bit closer. But that forces you to bring the image in closer. So now you're looking at something that's only 25 centimeters away. And if you do that all day, your eyes will get tired. It's kind of like reading all day. You get very tired from that. But notice what happens. So let's go back to the equation that we know from lenses, that 1 over the focal length equals 1 over the object distance plus 1 over the image distance. Solving that for the object distance, we now will figure out by placing the image over here with our eyes where the object distance needs to be. So let's calculate that. So this is equal to the image distance of minus 25 centimeters, because it's in front of the lens, that makes it a negative image distance. Focal length of 5 centimeters divided by minus 25 minus 5, so this is equal to minus 125 over minus 30, which is an object distance of 125 divided by 30, which is 4.167 centimeters. So 4.167 centimeters. So what we do now is place the object at slightly over 4 centimeters instead of 5 centimeters. What does that do? Well, now we can calculate the new magnification. And now since we forced the image to be at the distance of 25 centimeters, and we know the distance of the object, we can now calculate the magnification using this equation, minus s prime over s. So this is equal to minus a 4 point, let's see, minus, oh, s prime, that's where the image is located, so that would be equal to minus minus 25 centimeters divided by the object distance, which is 4.167 centimeters. And let's calculate what that is equal to. And notice the magnification has now increased to 6 rather than the magnification of 5 when we use relaxed viewing. So when we use a relaxed state, or perhaps relaxed viewing, maybe I'll just write the word viewing to be in sync with my title. So when we use relaxed viewing, you can see that you allow the image to float off to a very large distance away. The relative height to distance will still be the same, so this angle theta prime doesn't change, and therefore we can calculate the magnification using relaxed viewing to be 5. But then when we place the object in a little bit closer, it causes the image to be a little bit bigger. So now we have a new theta prime, which is bigger than the old theta prime. And using the old technique of using your lens equation, we can find the object distance where the object needs to be placed. And then from that, we're able to calculate the new magnification, where now we can see that it's more, it's 6 instead of 5. Now, notice that in order to do that, you have to force the image to be close at the, what we call, near point of the eye. That causes eye fatigue. But if you want to see a little bit bigger, things a little bit bigger, you could do that temporarily to get just a slightly better look at what you're looking at. And that is how it's done.
Why is it you use S prime over S there and theta prime over theta for magnification?
Good question. So the reason why we use theta prime over theta before is because that way we allow the image to be anywhere we want. We can place it here, or we can put it farther away, and that ratio doesn't change, that angle doesn't change. So it's essentially this angle divided by this angle, no matter where you place the image. And that's accomplished by putting the object at the focal point. Once you bring the object at a point close to the focal point, you don't know what this new angle is. And so therefore, you have to go to this equation to find the magnification, because you don't know what the new angle is at that point. I guess you could calculate it, but it could be done like this.
Change the magnification also if you change the distance from the magnifying glass to your eye?
Yes, it does. And I guess that warrants some other videos in the future. Yeah, so if you then, for example, go farther away and the magnifying glass is farther away, you do get something different again. So we'll have to calculate that. Yeah, but yeah, that's actually an interesting thing, but that can be done. And I like to play with my reading glasses, because when I place my reading glasses far away, I can see amazing stuff on the far away. So we'll do some videos on that as well. Looks like there's